mind. This world is not meant for you. Run, boy, run. They're trying to catch you. Run, boy, run. Running is a victory. Run, boy, run. Beauty lies behind the hills.
Oh, I say, what a shot.
Run, boy, run.
Beautiful volley.
The sun will be guiding you. Run, boy, run. They're dying to stop you. Run, boy, run. This race is a prophecy. Run, boy, run.
Oh, wonderful
break
smash.
Break up from society.
I've never seen that before.
War is an awful day, hey. And you don't have to hide away, yeah. This ride is a journey to run, boy, run. The secret inside of you.
There's a new champion.
This race is a prophecy. Run, boy, run. And disappear in the trees.
It's Leva. He's won it.
The simple refusal to give in.
Follow that band.
Day, hey.
No, it's England. It has to rain sometime.
You'll be my boy. But for now, it's time to run. It's time to run. Tomorrow is another day. Hey. When the night fades away, yeah. You'll be my boy. But for now, it's time to run. It's time to run.
Thanks, everybody.
Congratulations, Roger Federer. Serena Slam, it's happened.
There's a new man at the helm of men's tennis.
Right, I'm going to try this and it's not going to be easy.
The waiting is over.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this very special Centre Court centenary celebration. Please welcome your hosts, three-time Wimbledon singles champion John McEnroe, and in her 30th and final year presenting the championships, Queen of Wimbledon, Sue Barker.
Can I just say, hello, Wimbledon! Yeah!
Wow, thank you for that special welcome. It is a special day, this championship celebrating 100 years of this place, this centre court. And what did this centre court mean to you, Mac?
Wow, I'm not even sure I remember playing here. It was so long ago. No, I'm just kidding. First time I came here was 45 years ago. It was unbelievable. My legs were shaking when I came on the court for the first time. I feel fortunate to be part of history a little bit on this fantastic court when I played my great buddy Bjorn Borg in the 1980 Wimbledon final. Thank you. Which I lost, by the way, so you can cut the applause. But the next year, when I won the Wimbledon for the first time in 1981, it was the greatest moment of my professional career. For that moment or minute or so, I felt like I could fly out of the stadium. So, unbelievable privilege to be here. Awesome day here we have today. I can't believe they're playing on Sunday.
And just one question, I mean, got to say a little word about the tiebreak as well. That tiebreak with Bjorn Borg. Everyone remembers that, everyone.
I wish we could have stopped after the tiebreak. It was an unbelievable, it felt like it was never going to end. I have people, I think about 100,000 people, Sue, have come up to me over the years telling me they're at this match. And it's only a 15,000 seat stadium. So I'm taking that as a compliment.
Well, we have got so much to look forward to. We've got a few little surprises, and also a little later on, many familiar faces will be making their way back onto Centre Court, former singles champions who have graced these hallowed lawns. Well, while we are enjoying the majesty inside Centre Court, Claire Balding is just outside.
Thank you, Sue. And this is a stadium that is as beautiful from the outside as it is on the inside. The plaque here commemorating the opening of it in 1922 by His Majesty King George V. And everywhere you look, the colours of Wimbledon reflected in the planting, but the history as well. The great British singles champions, Virginia Wade, Anne Jones, Angela Mortimer here. But the ivy gives it a feeling that it is a living, breathing stadium. It's very formal as well. Good afternoon. Good afternoon to you. And down here, the other two British women who have won the singles title, Dorothy Round and Kitty Godfrey, back in 1924 and 1926. It really is a place that oozes class as well as history. And over the years, various modifications have been made. Here now, on the balcony, is where the singles champions come forward to show the trophy down to the adoring crowd. Now, the first television coverage here at Wimbledon was in 1937. And this year, we have a wonderfully restored scanner, a mobile control room, MCR21. It's been restored by ex-BBC staff. The camera here as well, dating back to the 60s, when this scanner would have been in use. And inside, we would have had the director and the editor and engineering staff. Look at this. Oh, my word, it is absolutely beautiful. This in itself is a piece of history. And it's the perfect place from which to look back on the history of Centre Court. As I say, Brian, run VT.
The name says it all. Every summer, the centre of the tennis world. Built in the 1920s, when the club moved to its current site, a stadium and theatre was called for to reflect the growth of the game. Centre Court was born. And what things it's seen in its long life, like so many buildings damaged during the war, and still bearing the scars in the following years. And then, more settled times, seeing only minor changes in five decades, but always watching over the champions who came and won and gathered again at the parade for a new millennium. But the new century and the British weather called for a new look, with the roof that brought us inside, the roof that means play will always go on. And the essence, that feeling of a special place remains, the court to which we turn, the light to which we're drawn. This court, for a century, at the centre of it all.
Well, we've now made our way into the atrium, right by where the trophies are, the men's trophy over here. You've lifted that three times, John. Did that feel special?
Oh, are you kidding me? That feels unbelievable. This whole scenario is unbelievable. Serious goosebump time when the players are about to go out on the court, but you're super excited. You get a chance to sort of view history as it's gone on here the past 100 years on Center Court. So this is an amazing moment and a tense moment.
Absolutely. And this trophy, the ladies' trophy, for me is the most beautiful in sport, the Venus Rosewater dish. And just as you walk onto court, you go under the Kipling saying, if you can meet with triumph and disaster. Did you have more triumphs or disasters?
Well, I think I had more triumphs, I'd like to say. I was always trying to figure out exactly what that meant and try to live up to it, because I knew it was important. That's all I knew.
And then we look over at the honours board here, and looking from 1980, what an era that was for you, John, with Bjorn and your good friend Jimmy Connors as well.
Oh, well, that's that, I like your sense of humor there. But you get a chance to view history. You see the past and the future. It's amazing. And thank you for showing off that early 80s stuff. I appreciate that.
It was a special era, that, wasn't it? With you and Bjorn, you have such a wonderful rivalry.
Oh, are you kidding? I loved every minute of it. I thought it was a special time. Hopefully people still remember it and view it fondly, hopefully. What? Whoa, 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 whoa. You can't be serious. That wasn't in the script. Sue, what are we going to do?
We're all going on a summer holiday, no more working for a week or two. Fun and laughter on a summer holiday, no more worries for me or you. For a week or two. Well, we're going where the sun shines brightly. We're going where the sea is blue. We've seen it in the movies. So let's see if it's true. Everybody has a summer holiday, doing things they always wanted to. So we're going on a summer holiday to make our dreams come true. We're going where the sun shines brightly. We're going where the sea is blue. We've seen it in the movies, so let's see if it's true. Key change. Everybody has a summer holiday, doing things they always wanted to. So we're going on a summer holiday to make our dreams come true. Make our dreams come true. For me and you.
Let's hear it for Sir Cliff Richard. So didn't you have a
stop,
thing
stop,
with
stop,
that
stop,
guy,
stop. Thank you. We'll move on. Thank you, John. We'll move on. Thank you.
Tell me about that.
No. From pop royalty to broadcasting royalty. And this man, he used to fill those rain delays in the 80s and 90s magnificently. We both had the privilege of working alongside him. He's in the royal box today. Please give him a huge welcome back to Centre Court. Des Lynam.
Thank you, Sue. Thank you, Matt.
Well, since 2009 on Centre Court and 2019 on Number One, rain delays have been a thing of the past, thanks to these state-of-the-art retractable roofs, which also allow play to continue into the night. The Centre Court roof was unveiled with an exhibition match featuring Agassi, Graf, Clijsters, and this man, Tim Henman. I'm just warning you, normally when these two are together, this gets totally
it's
out of
ugly,
control.
Yeah. Less behaviour. Less behaviour today.
But Middle Sunday, you have experience of Middle Sunday. We all remember that match against Paul Harhouse.
Yeah, that's right. 1997, terrible weather, no roof, way behind in the schedule. To have that opportunity, it was only the second time, I think, in the history of the tournament that we played on the Middle Sunday. I wouldn't necessarily say it was the best match, but in terms of the atmosphere, we had 15,000 that had queued overnight. And as the match unfolded, as usual, I made heavy weather of it. It went to a fifth set, and I ended up saving match point and winning 14-12 in the fifth. So in terms of the best atmosphere I ever played in, it was certainly that day in 1997.
Do you sort of wish, since you run things at the All England Club now, that you had that roof
bit.
Over the, that you had this roof a little bit earlier when you perhaps played Mr. Goran Ivanišević, I believe.
I think,
if I
could have one go at a match again, it would be 2001. Up 2-1, I just won the third set in 14 minutes. Goran, I think it's safe to say, had gone walkabout. I don't think he was in his best mental state at that stage. And when the rain came, I certainly would have benefited from this roof. But there you go. It's looking absolutely magnificent today. And it's great to see so many of you here as well.
You had an interesting day the other day. You were commentating on Novak Djokovic's match, and you had Leighton Hewitt alongside you and Goran Ivanišević facing you from the players' box, the two people that you probably played.
How'd that feel?
I thought it was bad enough when I'm commentating with McEnroe. You know, it's like, that's tough enough to look at. But Hewitt, I think, beat me, you know, 9 out of 10 times, and the one match, you know, that I play over in my mind is against Goran. So I look out the commentary box and I see him up in the players' box. So that was a tough afternoon. This is much better today.
Yeah, I tell you, Wimbledon has changed so much. We all agree. But what always remains the same is the tradition, isn't it, and the history of the game.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, this place epitomises history and tradition, but with the innovation. And you talk about the roof here, and you talk about the roof on number one. Some of the new facilities that have come over the years. It's incredible that there's so much change, but so much stays the same. And I think, you know, we reflect on the past 100 years. You know, hopefully there's going to be a lot of things that will continue for the next 100 years.
Absolutely. Thanks very much, Tim. I wonder where Claire is. Where's Claire?
Yeah. I just wanted to show you this view, because even though we're on the edge of London, it feels like we're in the English countryside. As you look across the southern courts, over all that gorgeous grass, to the spire of St Mary's in the distance in Wimbledon Village. And that is why the players love coming here. It feels different to any other sporting event anywhere in the world. Come inside, though, and immediately you feel that you should speak in hushed tones, because there is a certain formality to the members' area, and particularly to the Royal Box. We come past a picture here of the club as it was perceived in 1922 when they built it. Actually, they thought it was going to be something of a white elephant, but as we know, nothing could be further from the truth. And here in the Royal Box, oh my word, what a view. And this is going to be full of magnificent people. Brian Cox, I can see here, looking at stars of a different kind today, down there on court. I don't think they'll let me stay, Sue, so back to you.
I'm sure they will, Claire, I'm sure they will. Anyway, we are ready now for a very, very special moment to celebrate the 100 years of this incredible court, as we are going to invite back many former singles champions who have not only graced this court, but given us so many memorable memories. So, first of all, we are going to welcome onto court our one-time winners.
Please give it up for Angela Mortimer.
Anne Jones.
Stan Smith.
Jan Kodesh.
Pat Cash. The man who climbed into the stands, first man.
Conchita Martinez.
Martina Hingis.
Goran Ivanišević.
Leighton Hewitt.
Marion Bartoli.
Angelique Kerber.
Simona Halep. Next are two-time singles champions.
Stefan Edberg. And 20 other majors. Petra Kvitova.
And Andy Murray. Now to our three-time singles champions.
Margaret Court.
John Newcomb.
Chris Everett.
And we wouldn't forget one more, ladies and gentlemen, John McEnroe. Now to our four-time singles champion.
You ready for this? Rod the Rocket Laver.
Next are five-time champions.
Okay, Bjorn Borg.
And Venus Williams. And now our six-time champions.
Billie Jean King.
And ladies and gentlemen, Novak Djokovic. Okay, any more? Oh yes, we have an eight-time champion.
His name is Roger Federer. We're going to start with Roger here. amazing
we'll
to see. Oh, no,
I'm
sorry.
With Billie Jean, shall we? Billie Jean. No, take a microphone, Billie Jean. Take a microphone there. There we go.
Billie Jean King has done, in my opinion, more for our sport than anyone in the history of tennis. Tell me how it feels and what this Wimbledon center court means to you.
Well, I played my very first match at Wimbledon as a 17-year-old. I played my first match ever at Wimbledon out here against Yola Ramirez, who was seeded fifth that year. And we started late, so we had 2 days. I had 2 days on this court. It was magical and wonderful, and I knew I belonged here. That's all. I just knew it was so wonderful. And I love history, and I love the fact we have so many people here today. It means so much. And Martina could not be with us, and she won 9 women's singles. So I'd just like to say I'm sorry she's not here, but she surely carried me the year I won 20, and then I helped coach her in 90 to help her win her 9th singles. And of course, she won 20 Wimbledons as well. So anyway, it's always more fun to talk about others. So that's good.
Yeah,
and thank you so much.
I know she'll be watching, and we all send our love. Novak, what does this court mean to you? Was this a court that you dreamed about when you were a kid?
Absolutely. I want to say first that it's an absolute honor and privilege to be on the same court with the legends of our sport, the people that have paved the way for myself and many, many generations. Gosh, I feel more nervous than when I'm playing. Definitely this court has been truly special for my childhood. I mean, the first image of tennis that I've seen was I was 4 or 5 years old. I saw Pete Sampras win his first Wimbledon, and you know, so I always dreamed of being here, competing, hopefully winning it as well. The dreams came true, and I was really blessed. And back in 2011, as probably the highlight of my career, most beautiful moment. So every time I step out on this wonderful court, I relive those memories. So it's truly an honor to be here again.
I'm sliding over here at Novak. Oh, incredible. I don't even know what to ask this guy other than thank you for being here, number one. And the mic is yours. You know, tell us about your feelings about playing on this center court all these years and maybe whether or not you'll be playing again here.
Yeah, I've been lucky enough to play a lot of matches on this court. Feels awkward to be here today in a different type of role, but it's great to be here with, like Novak said, with all the other champions, and this court has given me my biggest wins, my biggest losses. One of my highlights, of course, has been in 2001, walking out here with Pete Sampras, who I'd like to give a big shout out to. He's also one mm-hmm. that I think has inspired a lot of us to play. And just try to also be successful here and represent the sport well. And I hope I did that. And I hope I can come back, like you said, one more time.
Yeah. We hope so.
We have really missed you, Roger. Have you missed being at Wimbledon this year as a player?
Of course, I've missed being here. I would have loved to be here. I knew walking out here last year it was going to be a tough year ahead. I maybe didn't think it was going to take me this long to come back, but the knee has been rough on me. But I've been happy. I've been happy at home. It's been a good year, you know, regardless of tennis or not. Kids are fine. My wife's great. We're happy at home. We traveled so much for so many years that it's just great to be here this year. I didn't know if I should make the trip, but I'm happy standing right here, right now. So
you've made everybody's day.
Yeah, darn absolutely. Right.
And out of all the memories, Roger, is there one that stands out here on this court?
2001, the match against Sampras, and then, of course, my first win in 2003 against Marc Philippoussis. you remember what it meant to me. Don't do it again.
Sorry about that. Yes, I think we saw that. But thank you to all of our champions for coming here. Please stay here because to celebrate these wonderful champions who are standing on this court and who have graced this court, we are going to do it in the company of the incredibly talented Freya Ridings.
Standing on the platform, watching you go. It's like no other pain I've ever known. To love someone so much, to have no control.
Thank you. That was beautiful. Thank you.
One final word to the crowd, and on behalf of all the players, I just want to say that we're going to be lost without you. After 30 years of covering this tournament magnificently, please give it up for Sue Barker.
Yeah.
But this is about the tournament, and all I can say is that from now on, John McEnroe is going to be commentating on court 17 after that, going off script. But thank you, that really does mean the world to me, it really does. And just before we go, before we let these wonderful champions go, they are going to have their photograph taken on this centre court. But one last time, ladies and gentlemen, these wonderful Wimbledon champions!